a form of a sine inverse function, then it is easier to calculate because it comes to be a, then the domain is well defined in that cases. So to avoid the logarithmic function, because that has the its limitation, we can easily find out the function through using the hyperbolic inverse functions. So in general, we have calculated the hyperbolic and the inverse hyperbolic functions, which are related with the trigonometric functions, or in general the exponential and the logarithmic functions. In next section, we will discuss the application of all these functions in the electrical circuits, that how in electrical and electronic circuit the sine and the cosine or the hyperbolic functions are used, and the complex numbers are used to calculate the resultant of any circuit, or the current flow, or the voltage calculation, or the resultant calculation. And using the formula I equal to V by R, we can calculate the easily the impedance of the circuits and the combination.